Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. First and foremost, I would like to greet a very warm welcome, everyone, to this auspicious evening hosted by Kechara Soup Kitchen.
Yang berhormat Datuk Seri Shahrizat Abdul Jalil, Minister of Women, Family and Community Development, distinguished guests.
Yes, and also we would like to welcome Yang Bahagia, Datuk Dr. Victor Wee. Come on, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it from the President of Kechara Soup Kitchen, Ms. Ruby Kong, to deliver a few words.
Good evening, Yang Berhormat, Datuk Sri Shahrizat Abdul Jalil, Minister of Women, Family and Community Development, our patron, Datuk Dr. Wee, distinguished guests and friends. Thank you for being here this evening to support Kechara Soup Kitchen, fondly known as KSK. First, I would like to take this opportunity to thank Datuk Sri for taking time out of her tremendously busy schedule to grace this dinner. She always cares about the welfare of others, as can be seen by her attendance here this evening. Personally, I know she has several appointments already and could have easily said she couldn't attend. I just wanted to say that I deeply appreciate the effort she makes to support causes like this, which is to help the underprivileged and less fortunate. Her ministry is crucial to the development of Malaysia because as we are all progressing, we need to make sure that nobody gets left behind. KSK is honoured to complement the government's welfare programs, which is a huge portfolio and with tight resources. All of us as Malaysians can play a part to support the welfare of all, and KSK is humbled to play a part in this. KSK has come a long way since we first started in 2006. Back then, there were just 5 of us giving out 20 packets of food every Saturday night. These days, our volunteers deliver out more than 800 packets of food every weekend. Due to their ever-changing movements, fear of authority or lack of awareness, some people slip through the net of help cast by Datuk Sri Shahrizat's ministry. So as Malaysians, we come together to support our government's work in areas that they cannot reach. And this is precisely in these areas that KSK is helping. However, as the amount of food we distribute increases, it means that the number of homeless people is increasing, and this is not a good thing. KSK's real wish is that we are out of the job because there is no more clients to serve. Until that day, however, let me first introduce KSK to those of you who may not know about us yet. Yes, KSK is an NGO that feeds the homeless and urban poor of the Klang Valley. However, KSK is also an NGO working towards a long-term solution for our homeless clients by helping them to find homes, jobs, and care. We achieve this by interacting with our homeless clients. We are interested in their lives. It's as simple as that. We want to know about them. We want to know who they are, why they are there, and how we can help. This can be for the things that we take for granted every day, like having an IC, having access to medical help, or just having clean clothes to wear. Since 2006, KSK has been a mobile food distribution service. Being of net nature, inevitably, we sometimes miss out some of our clients. However, through the kindness of our friends who offered us a friendly loan, KSK recently acquired a building just off Jalan Imbi in the center of KL. This building will be our permanent home. With our new building, for the first time ever, we will have a place where our clients can come to every day of the week. We will be able to offer them hot, nutritious food every day. We will be able to give them medical care when they need it. They will be able to do their laundry and receive assistance to get a job. This is what KSK is really about, to help the homeless help themselves back into society as positive contributors, and thus to regain their dignity. There is no beating about the bush here. In order for us to do all that, we need funds. We need funds to renovate and equip our building so that it fulfills the purpose that it is there. We need funds to hire staff, and we hope that some of these will be the homeless themselves, so that they can help people who are still in the situation that they used to be in. We will need funds for food supplies. We will need funds for basic medical kits. We also need counselors, doctors. If you know anyone who'd like to volunteer, please let me know. Otherwise, we will have to hire them. And for that, we will need funds too. So today, on behalf of everyone who will benefit from your kind sponsorship and donation, I would like to thank you for stepping up to help KSK to fulfill its mission to benefit others, regardless of race, gender, or religion. If any of you would like to know more about KSK or wish to contribute your time, skills, or funds, please let me know or my team members, and we'll be very happy to see how we can work with you. In what has become a KSK's tradition, I would like to recite a few motivational verses written by a great Buddhist saint, Shantideva. May all beings everywhere, plagued by sufferings of body and mind, obtain an ocean of happiness and joy by virtue of my merits. May no living creature suffer, commit evil, or ever fall ill. May no one be afraid or belittled with a mind weighed down by depression. May the blind see forms and the deaf hear sounds. May those whose bodies are worn with toil be restored on finding repose. May the naked find clothing, the hungry find food. May the thirsty find water and delicious drinks. May the poor find wealth, those weak with sorrow find joy. May the hopeless find hope, constant happiness and prosperity. May there be timely rains and bountiful harvest. May all the medicines be effective and wholesome prayers bear fruit. May all who are sick and ill quickly be freed from their ailments. Whatever diseases there are in the world, may they never occur again. May the frightened cease to be afraid, and those bound be freed. May the powerless find power, and the people think of benefiting each other. For as long as space remains, for as long as sentient being remains, until then may I too remain to dispel the miseries of the world. Beautiful verses, aren't they? This is what our volunteers recite every weekend before they go on their distribution rounds to make this activity even more meaningful. Please enjoy your dinner, and I hope you have a pleasant evening and a great year ahead. Thank you all.
Thank you, our Lady President.
Thank you, Ms. Ruby.
Ladies and gentlemen, round of applause for Yang Bahagia, Dato' Dr. Wee, to deliver a speech now.
Yang Berhormat, Datuk Seri Shahrizat Abdul Jalil, Minister of Women, Family and Community Development, Ms. Ruby Kong, President of Kechara Soup Kitchen, honored guests, ladies and gentlemen, good evening and salam sejahtera satu Malaysia. On behalf of the Kechara Soup Kitchen and all of us, we would like to thank the Minister for being with us this evening. Datuk Seri, we really appreciate your presence here because we know that you make time despite your very busy schedule. Ladies and gentlemen, as the patron of the Kechara Soup Kitchen, or KSK, I'm happy to welcome all of you to this dinner and thank you so much for your support. Chinese New Year is only 7 days to come, and it is a really wonderful way to celebrate Chinese New Year by performing some meritorious deeds and making contribution to this dinner so that KSK can pay for the newly acquired building that will be used to serve the poor and the homeless. The idea of establishing KSK was mooted by His Eminence Tsem Tulku Rinpoche, the spiritual guide to Kechara House. Tsem Rinpoche was given away for adoption as a baby and had not experienced the love of a mother or a father, something that most of us have taken for granted. Since childhood, he has experienced the pain of neglect, hunger, and abuse. And as a result, his heart goes to the underdogs, to the poor, and the neglected. When he was 16 years old, he ran away from home and traveled in winter from New Jersey in the East Coast of the United States to Los Angeles on the West Coast. Through the biting cold and without a penny in his pocket, he witnessed the suffering of other homeless people. He saw that hunger knows no barriers. When a person has no food, it does not matter what race or religion he comes from. His stomach will rumble with the pain of hunger. His body weakens from the lack of nutrition, and his health can quickly succumb to disease. Ladies and gentlemen, KSK was established barely 3 years ago, but its service has expanded from distributing 20 packages of food, as Ruby Kong has just mentioned, when it first started, to over 800 packages on weekends today. Every time the number of homeless grows, there are more headaches for the organizers of KSK to get more donations to meet its commitments, and more pressure to recruit volunteers. Tonight, I must compliment Ruby Kong, Julia Tan, Justin Chia, and the other volunteers for the hard work they have put in to enable KSK to respond to the increasing demand for food by the homeless. I must also acknowledge the contribution of food donors, as well as the media, for creating awareness on the mission of KSK. I myself have participated in the food distribution circuit, and it came to me as a surprise that there are so many homeless people in Kuala Lumpur. Well, we don't see them when you drive in nice cars, unless you specifically look for them. It is only when we get down from our cars and walk to look for them that you see the homeless people picking scraps of food, rummaging through the garbage for things that they could use, and sleeping beneath bridges. They come from all races, many are elderly, and are target of abuse and even theft of what little they have. Ladies and gentlemen, the main objective of KSK is not feeding more and more homeless, although this it will continue to do. The real goal is to get the homeless off the streets by finding shelter homes for them, or to help them to get jobs. And I'm happy to note that this month, KSK has managed to help 5 homeless people to get jobs. Now, that is a measure of success. In order to expand its services, KSK has bought a building off Jalan Imbi to be the permanent base for the soup kitchen. Once this place has been renovated, it should provide the homeless with hot food, laundry and shower facilities, medical aid, as well as help and counseling. By providing this type of help, it is possible to get some of the homeless to get jobs, and more importantly, to bring dignity back into their shattered lives. Ladies and gentlemen, let me call upon you to take this opportunity to reach out to your fellow human beings and touch their lives with your compassion. Show them that you care, just as you feel blessed to have a loving family, a stable job, food on your table, and a roof above your head. Show that you have not forgotten about another fellow human being who is homeless and whose stomach rumbles with hunger. While we enjoy our life's blessings, let us not forget those who are not as fortunate as us. Our human life is short, and it is not to be used for ourselves and our loved ones alone. It is to be used to bring benefit to others so that they may be relieved from the suffering and gain some happiness and peace. This is our service to humanity. Please use this opportunity to practice love and compassion. The qualities of charity, love and compassion are praised by all, regardless of what religion they subscribe to. By giving to the unfortunate, we plant the seeds of abundance that we harvest in due course. Just as we bring blessings into the life of others with our charity, we will receive blessings of abundance in our own lives. Ladies and gentlemen, in closing, I would like to thank the Minister of Women, Family and Community Development, Yang Berhormat, Datuk Sri Shahrizat Abdul Jalil, for honouring us with her presence. Thank you, Datuk Sri. I would also like to thank all of you for your support. I hope that you will tell others about the work of KSK so that they too might come forward to help with feeding the homeless. Remember, hunger knows no barriers. I'd like to wish all of you who are celebrating Chinese New Year, Kong Zi Fa Zai, and those of you who are not, to have a good break during this festive season. Please enjoy the dinner and entertainment, and thank you.
Thank you. Come on, everybody, let's all stand up and give Yang Berbahagia Datuk a round of applause. Come on, let's all stand up. Come on, come on, come on. That was a fantastic speech. Come on, tepuk tangan, everybody.
Come on, big round of applause for Yang Berbahagia Datuk Dr. Victor B.
Now, I would like to invite on stage Yang Berhormat Datuk Sri Shahrizat Abdul Jalil, Minister of Women, Family and Community Development, to say a few words. Come on, a big hand, ladies and gentlemen.
Big hand for Datuk Sri, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Bill and Dee. Assalamualaikum. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Yang Berbahagia Datuk Dr. Victor Wee, patron of Kechara Soup Kitchen Society. Miss Ruby Kong, president of Kechara Soup Kitchen Society, dan semua sukarelawan. Yang saya hormati Datuk Chi Pek Kiat, Buddhist Missionary Society Malaysia. Datuk Syed Abdul Rahman, CEO National Welfare Foundation. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Terlebih dahulu bagi pihak kementerian, saya ingin ucapkan terima kasih kepada Kechara Soup Kitchen kerana telah sudi menjemput saya dan beberapa pegawai daripada kementerian untuk bersama-sama kita pada malam ini di dalam satu usaha untuk menentukan bangunan yang diimpikan itu menjadi kenyataan. InsyaAllah kementerian kita akan membantu sedaya yang boleh untuk menentukan bahawa usaha Kechara Soup Kitchen itu menjadi kenyataan. Bagi pihak kerajaan, saya ingin merakamkan ucapan tahniah dan syabas kepada Datuk Dr. Victor dan juga Puan Ruby kerana dan semua yang terlibat, termasuklah sukarelawan, all the volunteers, kerana telah pun saya tengok mampu untuk mengadakan satu majlis yang begitu gilang gemilang, it's like a gala night, ya, untuk menentukan semua yang mempunyai hati yang suci dan juga generous untuk memberi sumbangan yang sewajarnya. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the government, especially Ministry of Women, Family and Community Development, I would like to record our great appreciation to the work done tonight, especially by the patron, Datuk Dr. Victor and Ms. Ruby Kong, volunteers and members of the committee tonight. I have to say that it is not easy. I've been to many functions. It's certainly not easy to be able to put together, you know, this really glorious and eminent crowd that you have tonight. And I want to say a special word to all the VIPs sitting at the main table, led by Datuk Kamaluddin and Datin Sharin and Syed Anwar and all of that. Don't forget to to donate generously. yeah, Tuan Syed Anwar and Bank, you know, I understand Tan Sri Azman is rather interested in what Kechara Soup is doing. Esther, you must write more about, you know, the noble efforts by Kechara Soup Kitchen. We also have Patrice Pakiam, I understand. And also Mr. Niao and so on and so forth. Madam, you know, and all of you, we all must come together to make sure that, you know, noble effort such as this receives nothing but the best. Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to take a little bit of time to share with you that the government of today take welfare very seriously. For this year alone, my ministry has received $715 million, $715 million to help at the moment now the number of recipients registered, which is something like 360,000 Malaysians to receive welfare aid. It's not a small bill. And I can share with you as well that we do give welfare aid to our old folks, to our disabled, to children of single mothers, to those who are helping the disabled, and those who are not able to work, and so on and so forth. We also give out aid for families who are not able, where the parents are not able to work. And in total, as I said, this year I will be spending no less than 715 million. However, that is not enough. For as far as the government is concerned, we will do the best that we can, even though Malaysia is not a welfare state. It's not a welfare state. However, I have to remind each and all of you that the best welfare gift a government and an administration can give its people, the best welfare gift is to make sure that there is stability in the country, there is a future, there is economic growth, and a nation of happy people, so that, you know, the likes of Dr. Victor and Miss Ruby can congregate in a glorious place like this to do our bit for a noble cause. Wherever I go, as Minister in charge of welfare, it is my duty to remind all of us, because if we do not have a country which is strong, a government which is strong, and a happy nation, we will have millions of people who are out of jobs, and they will not be able to afford not only food, but to buy one hot and happening tiger from the table. So there you are, don't forget about that, especially all you corporate people. Thank you for, you know, the support that you're giving the government of today. Under Datuk Sri Najib, inshallah, we will do our best. And I have to say that I travel to America quite often, and the first time I ever saw, you know, cases of homelessness, which was really in dire straits, was on the streets of New York. And, you know, America is a rich country, but they do have, you know, NGOs like the Kechara Soup Kitchen doing their bit. And I'm really proud, Ruby, of the work that you and the other volunteers are doing. When I look at Ruby, she's the epitome of, you know, what's great in a woman, beauty and brains, or should I say brains and beauty first. And, you know, the fact that, you know, she could be doing many other things, but she has chosen, apart from the fact that she's a very successful entrepreneur, in the oil business, no less. But she and her friends have chosen to spend their time. And because I think this is our investment, not only for today, but for the hereafter. Muslims, like Buddhists too, and Christians and other races, we believe that you must do your bit, not only for this life, but for the hereafter. And Ruby, believe you me, inshallah, you know, the satisfaction that you get this year, but in this life, I'm sure will be translated in the hereafter. So good luck, God bless. I'm here to for all of you, and just as a, you know, just as a appetizer, I would like to say that because I want to bring home, my daughter is here with me as well, and I know she likes tigers, and I do too. I'm a lion, actually. You know, I'm a Leo. But when I saw the tiger on the table, I said, wow, I really must capture the tiger. This is the year of the tiger. And we must do very well for the people. That's why I decided that I'm going to pay $50,000 for the tigers on the table on behalf, you know, on behalf of the government. So we are going to, the tigers that I bought just now is 50,000 gift from the government in support and appreciation of the fantastic noble work that Kechara Soup Kitchen has been doing. And should you need any help after this, you know where to find me. So thank you for inviting me, and to everybody who's celebrating Chinese New Year. I celebrate Chinese New Year too as a Malaysian. An early Kong Yi Fat Choy. Thank you. Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam. Everybody, let's all stand up and give Yang Berhormat Datuk Seri a round of applause.
Yes, 50,000 lead.
Yeah.
Isn't that wonderful?
Oh my God.
Such an auspicious day. Come on, it has to be louder than that. I know you haven't had your dinner yet. Thank you, Datuk Seri. Thank you for the wonderful and very inspiring speech.
Amin, 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 murah rezeki yang berhormat dan juga kerajaan Malaysia.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight marks also a celebration of how much Kechara Soup Kitchen has grown. It used to just feed 15 people, distribute 15 packets of food when they first started over the weekend. And today, they feed 900 people. They distribute 900 packets of food over the weekend. I think that deserves a clap, no? So tonight, you have seen two cheques. You have 50,000 and 30,000. And then you heard a lot about the purpose for tonight. The growth of Kechara Soup Kitchen will continue, which is why the call for the building and the necessary renovations to provide more for the homeless, which is why you're here tonight to create the funds to do so. Many a times we see people homeless and we detach ourselves. That's not us. I don't know this person. Tonight is not about what you know. It's more about what you do not know. Why they are homeless, some of you might even justify by saying they chose to be. Maybe, perhaps you're right. Maybe they did choose to be. Why? Their circumstances, the consequences, made them have that choice, or shall we say, no choice. So, in many ways, there are certain things in life that's difficult and hard to accept, we ignore. If you've done that for many years, I just ask you tonight not to. And then we always say we don't have time to go help them. Well, Kechara Soup Kitchen people and their volunteers do. They have the time to do that. So tonight, I ask of you to be grateful for how fortunate you are. And because you are that fortunate not to be homeless, do something. Do something from your heart and let it transform to something from your wallet. Because just thinking about what you can do does nothing. So I ask you to take action and do something and contribute to the funds that's required for Kechara Soup Kitchen to do what you would like to do.
These are the volunteers. Come on, run.
Come.
We have young people, we have old people, we have ugly people, we have beautiful people. Come on.
Beautiful.
This side. Oh, this is a pretty one. Can we have the beautiful one here? And the ugly one this side. Are you going to auction this now?
Yeah.
How much are you going to start?
I'm going to start with 100.
Okay,
these 500.
Anyone? 500. We got one here. 500 is anything here.
Come on, let me hang up with Mr. Francisco from Philip Karen. Thank you very much, Shirley. Thank you very much. So kind of you. You definitely, God bless you, will definitely go to heaven. I love you.
Shirley, now we have a check presentation. We have a check of 30,000 ringgit.
Woo!
From
the million crew, as well as the Malaysian settler. Okay, a cheque of 30,000 ringgit from the million group.
Thank you, million group.
As well as the Malaysian settler.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. It's wonderful having you here today.